I want to say thank you from the bottom of our hearts. We're thanking our other siblings. it's growing up and being daughter of principal of FDC Kano, principal of FDC. But honestly, if you know me very well, you know that I don't have.
You know what? You didn't give me career milk that time.
See. But honestly, it was challenging for us because everybody had an expectation from you that you're a principal's daughter, so you should be good. So, but you know, just listening to him and now where we are in our lives, I see myself doing the same things that he did to me, to my own children. I have two girls. And it's so amazing to see that people actually remember him. Someone sent me a Facebook post about my dad, and I was like, oh my God. We the kids, the biological children, we don't appreciate him enough. Let me say, so when I see people actually that are not his real kids coming to appreciate him, it really goes a long way in our own hearts. I mean, we are so proud to call him father. And so many people, they said before us, went to see him as well, I think about 2 years ago. You know, it's really, 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 really touching. And we don't take it for granted at all. So if I want to reasons why I said, even if I had to travel, I would have to be in Nigeria today because I wanted to say thank you personally. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Thank you for showing him so much love. In his old age, he really needs to be celebrated. Thank you very, 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 very much.
The brainchild of a chat room, which started about 3 years ago. It's just about 15, 20 guys. And basically, at the time, it was just the usual 4 years, actually, 4 years. I think it was a BlackBerry chat room that had about 15, 20 guys. And all we did back then was the usual, you know, just back and forth banter about sports, politics, and whatever. And there came a time, we're all like, you know what, we gotta do better than this. It can't just be our usual everyday, share your mobile fighting, today everybody, we are family fighting, wherever the chat room. But anyways, the time came, we decided, 3 years from, at the time, 3 years from that point, it'll be 30 years that we actually got into FDC of the movie. And it actually will make sense if we use that opportunity to try to do something for the school. And so we decided, hey, those of us in the chat room, let's agree on a certain amount of money, let's start putting it together. And we actually sent a couple of guys. So guys were kind enough to try for the volume, to pretty much check out those things we can actually do as far as ongoing projects that maybe contribute to, or maybe we'll start a fresh project altogether. And that was Gokisho Beso, Mr. Yebe, Gerald Osuro, Kenny Kofisina, I think there was one other person. Anyways, they went out. Turns out all the projects they had ongoing, the least at the time was probably 3.5 million. And this was a chapter that had just about 20 guys. And at the time, even getting the 15K from the guys in the chat room, you know, it took a little while. And so, after a while, we basically decided, you know what? Instead of us dilly-dallying about when we are going to come up with 3.5 million, why don't we just continue to drop money? And maybe that time will come when we have a reasonable amount of money, we can tie it to something that we can actually do. And it turns out that one of us, Mr. Tunde Shobowale. Shobowale, right? Engineer Shobowale. And this is quite interesting. Guess what? Tunde Shobowale's kid. Is it kids or kid? In Odogwu. Tunde actually has a kid in FDC Odogwu right now. Isn't that awesome? What? He has been running. Okay. Let's forget that part of the story. So anyhow, he was appointment because he goes to the food and he had a relationship with the principal. And they actually had a conversation as far as what we can do is perhaps come up with a Gary processing plant. It turns out the set before us, I think 90 or 91 set, they actually did a fish pond, which really worked out for the school. And we decided, you know what, maybe we can do this. At the time, the impression we had was it would be something that would cost under $1 million. That we, you know, we're working with doing something that will cost $1 million or less. However, when the principal came up with the bill of quantity, as far as what needed to be done, it was different from what we were working with. Now, as far as bill of quantity is concerned, Engineer Shewale happens to, that's his field. He has the bill of quantity, they've been cracking the numbers or whatever. He's gonna come up now to give us a breakdown of the numbers, what we may be able to do as far as what we have, what we may need to do as far as, I mean, we might need to do a little more, but trust me, we've done about 80% of the work. And honestly, I want to thank everyone that in one way or the other, sorry, $5 million in the coffers. $1.25 million, actually. So, Tunde will be telling us what he has as far as the bill of quantity is concerned and what we may need. So I'm going to hand over to Tunde at this point. Thank you, guys.
Thank you very much. Yeah, nice meeting all of you guys once again. Yeah, you know, when we got hold of the principal, you know, it's a federal government school, and for us to do anything in that school, we have to follow the normal due process. So we cannot present the bill on our own. So they have to get in touch with the Federal Ministry of Lands and Housing, who is in charge of all jobs that is being done on the premises. Even if you want to do renovation, they have to get approval from them. So we approached them, they gave us a bill. I've studied the bill, and it is about 2.6 million to deliver a cassava processing factory in the school premises. But we are not giving it out on contract. We, as 91 said, we are going to project manage the project. So if we are going to project manage it, I believe we need to save a lot of cost. Because we are going to do it through direct labor. It's not something we issue to somebody go and build for us and we sleep. So it's our 2.6, we don't need to fear. You know, the principal initially said it's going to cost about 500,000. Yeah, and you know, we're just asking an ordinary person, how much will you build a duplex? He will tell you, I can build it for 10 million. But when you get the bills from the engineer or from the architect, then you have to start scratching your head. But nevertheless, we have the bill in our hands. We'll approach the school, we have 2.6 there, but I know we'll definitely have to save not less than 30% of the total cost if we are doing it ourselves. So, I don't have a, the way I'm looking at it, I think it's something we can even do with our 1.5. Because we have a lot of us that we are in the built industry. And when we bring ourselves together, then we start bringing down the cost, item by item. Kufisiya is here. We have the element in the roof aspect. And I know it's been a lot of talk for us. To be honest, so we don't need to fear, we just need to do something. I think the 89 said they did something in like poultry, a fish farming project. A fish farming project there. And I think from what we have been there, they take some out of they take fish, I think once in a month from what they have there. So it takes the spill out of cost. And presently, I think about two or three medical doctors have pulled down the dispensary and want to put it up. So, as they said, I don't think it is too much for us to give a cassava processing mill in that place. Because if we decide to renovate the building, it will cost us nothing less than 3-4 million. And the building will not be in our name, it's just for a period of 1 or 2 years. But if we have this building, a processing mill situated close to the main gate, You know, the location will be close to the main gate. Then we definitely have it as our project for life. It's going to be our project for life. I know the world is driving towards MSME now, small and medium scale enterprise. So we need to teach those children the way they can be self-sufficient in the moment they are getting out of school. Thank you very much.
We have like 1.25 million and you're saying we need like 2.6 to finish up this project. Can we start with the 1.2 now, or we need to have the 2.6 before we start that?
Yeah, we don't need to wait for more funds, because the more time we waste, the more the increase in price of materials. So then maybe we'll start up right away.
Good afternoon, everybody, once again. I think to just support what Tunde Shubwali just said, I had the opportunity of talking to somebody about the viability of the project. I was going to understand that even the major markets that you have around the Jebo Day axis, this is exactly what they all do. In the remote big farms, in the remote villages, around the whatever villages, they have things like this. They have people who process the garri. The finished products are taken into their body and they are sold. Now, one thing that they told me also was that they are sure the school is not only going to be producing it just for the students, they are going to also look at the economic end of it, as in sustaining the school, raising funds for other things. It's a viable thing. Ozan just asked about, do we start immediately? I believe from what they've given us, we can take care of the foundation and have the walls ready. The major area that will probably take the bulk of the fund will be bringing in the machinery, I believe, from the bill. It will be bringing in the machinery. So if we can start off now, and I believe that some of us can still and will still give more towards this project, if we can start off from what we have right now, I'm sure in the next couple of weeks we'll start seeing pictures of work going so far. So please, I would personally like for us to, even today, put something down, or at least put down a commitment, a reasonable one. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Jide is my name again. I'd like to say this. I've been opportune professionally to manage a project like this. But most of the time when we think of projects that work like this, we don't think about maintenance and repair. Now, that's the other end of the workability of any project. But please, let's look at it from this way. I'm just suggesting, the machines that you are talking about, let it be things that are either fabricated locally, because I know that such machines are fabricated locally for cassava processing. And let it be that the people who can maintain it will be people who are at short reach, so that you don't have a breakdown and the project dies a natural death in Nigeria. Thank you.
We have an efficiency, you know. For instance, I'm not trying to show off that I did at the 4 points, but I remember 4 points. When I came 4 years ago, it was beautiful. Now, just like one hotel in a solo or something. So, you know, but it's anyway, Bumi Kendi, I know you have something to say. Did you have something to say?
Yes,
thank you.
Good evening, everybody. It's nice seeing the active faces and beautiful faces. Yeah, I need to introduce myself again.
No, spell.
Peggy in the house.
Introduce yourself, Josh.
Oh, thank you, darling. Yeah. If you don't know, this is Peggy in the house anyway. Hey, Scoopy Sile, he gave me that name. We're talking about this garri processing. It's a very good idea. I'm happy to see everybody here. I'm not guilty, I'm not innocent of what I'm about to say. I'm also a guilty party out of it. But we are here now to celebrate something, 25 years. But if we, 30, thank you. I know I'm growing younger. Oh gosh, I'm old. And I can bet it that many of us, including Kenny Olugbenga, did not respond in the financial aspect of this talk. So for this thing to kick off and for us to be happy that we actually did something in this life, we have to bring to date, our own contribution. Let's do it. Mr. Obuse, are we having another meeting there? I'll find you all. We need to do our contribution. Please, let's do that so that this thing we're talking about, it should start here in this hall and end here. But we can look back and say we actually did it. Thank you very much.
The other sets are doing things. You don't let them remember the 91 sets as the 91 as the only set that cheated during the SSS 3 exam, or the guys that brought it to the girls' hostel. Please let them remember us for something more important, okay? So, Daniel Captain, come in. Oh no, come, it's time to eat. What was that prayer?
Oh, wait. What was that prayer again back in the day?
Okay, welcome everybody to eat.
You're ready to eat.
No striking, no rushing, no massacre or massacre. What did you guys call it back then?
Bow your heads for prayer. What I said, bow. No strike, you know. Golani. Ujo Obuse. Oju. No strike. Bless this food, O Lord, for Friday.
Amen.
Dinner, sir. DJ, do your thing, baby. Thank you.
Thank you.